the MC for this afternoon's reception. In the first instance, we would like to warmly welcome our guest of honour today, Brendan Kennelly, and it is of course appropriate that this civic honour is being conferred on Brendan in his native place. We would also like to welcome Brendan's extended family and his many friends and neighbours who have travelled from far and wide to be here this afternoon. Can I in the first instance say a special thank you to the members of Ballylongford called the Cathaoirleach for entertaining us over the past half hour. They're a very talented bunch and a credit to Ballylongford, so thank you very much.
This opportunity is left to be able to thank County Council for addressing today and to be here in beautiful Ballylongford, which you've all seen, and I can assure you to hear from us about the spectacular performances. That's good. I am particularly delighted as a local councillor to have been given the opportunity to speak about our special guest today and to present him with a civic honour on behalf of the 23 members of Kerry County Council. I would like to say a warm welcome to our Chief Executive, Myron Morrell, and to the many other officials from Kerry County Council. I especially want to welcome the many members of the Kennelly family, some who have travelled from Barrafield and are here today. It's flat land touching the River Shannon and the Atlantic, for the most part, pasture land, devoid in Canadian youth, mainly the farming community. The farmers, small farmers mostly, were generally not well off, but they loved to swim at night. They go to the local pub and bicycles on foot long before cows were available. And they would have a few fallen and two pines and pass away the night with reputations and telling stories and singing songs. We all cherish Brendan Kennelly as a literary hero, not really. In the same way we do John Deakin and Brian McKnight. Brendan's contribution of over 30 books of poetry has been supplemented by novels and plays and contributions to many others.
I'm honoured to be asked to say a few words. The arts are so important in our county, and the local authority is charged with, under the Arts Act, promoting access to, participation in, and standards of practice in the arts. And I think Brendan ticks all those boxes very well. Certainly, when I started back in the job 17 years ago, I asked Brendan's advice on a number of matters, and he always said, get young people involved in the arts. And as we've all seen in the last 6 months or so, at national level, the government is making a huge drive to do more so of that work, which is hugely important. With the poets, the writers, the painters, the filmmakers, the actors have been saying it for years. So Brendan was always hugely encouraging. Before we went to the e-version of our communication, we used to a printed booklet, and I send it to Brendan every few months, and I'd always get a letter back saying, well done and keep up the good work. And
a privilege for me to see you all. Lovely, handsome people with good wishes in your hearts and good thoughts in your minds. Thank you. And I'd like to thank all the members and management of Kerry County Council, especially Lass Cathaoirleach and Ballyman Liam Porto, who speaks so well. And Chief Executive Moira Morrell and Cathaoirleach Michael O'Shea. To express the honour I feel in trying to thank you all for enabling me to talk in the place where I was born and reared in the village of Ballylongford. Like all, I asked him, I said, have any piece of advice for me? And he said, simply, take it easy. And if you can't, take it easy. Take it as easy as you can. And to dance a step in the middle of the kitchen floor. And as he danced, he whistled. He made his own music, always in tune with himself. Well, nearly always, anyway. He's buried now in Lislofton Abbey, and when whenever I think of him, I go back beyond the old man, mind and body broken, to find the unbroken man. It is the moment before the dance begins. His lips are enjoying themselves, whistling an air. Oh, my dad, whatever happens.
Irrationality that is the very core of hope. Many